want to call Malin Hamdi and her team. Like I said before, Malin Hamdi is a really unique teacher in her own way, and she has really connected with her team in a way that's so unique. So we really appreciate that. So Malin Hamdi, welcome, please.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Salma Sharif, and we're the 2023 graduates for the girls. Today, we will be doing a small activity. Salma Abdurrazak will be reading for us the backstory of Surah Fatah. Asiya Ismail will be reading ayahs 1 through 9 of Surah Fatah. And Subaida Abdullahi will be reading the translation. Afterwards, three different students will come up and tell us one thing they learned from this surah.
I will be sharing the background story of the 48th surah in the Quran, Surah Al-Fatah. This surah was revealed in the 6th year of Hijr when the Prophet ﷺ was on his way back to Medina after concluding the Treaty of Hudaybiyah with the disbelievers. In the 6th year of Hijr, the Prophet ﷺ saw in a dream that he went to Mecca with his companions and performed Umrah. The Prophet's dream could not have been only a dream or purpose. Rather, it had to be some sort of divine motivation that the Prophet ﷺ was obligated to listen to. The Prophet told his companions and requested a public statement that he was leaving for Umrah and that the others could join him. About 1,400 to 1,800 companions joined him on that highly dangerous journey. They each carried one sword in their sheaths, which the pilgrims to the Kaaba were allowed to carry according to the traditional Arab customs. They carried no other weapons or any armor. When the Muslims were making their way near Mecca, they were stopped by the Quraysh. Then the Quraysh sent Urwa ibn Mas'ud, who held long negotiations with the Prophet, trying to persuade him to give up his intention on entering Mecca. The Prophet then replied that he and his companions had only come for a pilgrimage to the house of Allah. The Prophet ﷺ then sent Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu to let the Meccans know that the Muslims had come in peace only for pilgrimage to the house of Allah. When the Meccans delayed Uthman, the Prophet got the news that Uthman may have been killed. So he invited the 1,400 companions to give a pledge under a tree at a place called Hudaybiyah just outside of Mecca to defend the truth with their lives. He told the 1,400 companions, "You are the best people on the face of earth today." He also told them that they would never enter hellfire. Shortly after, Uthman returned safely and a peace agreement was signed between the Muslims and the Meccan idol worshippers. The agreement was called the Hudaybiyah Peace Agreement. According to the Hudaybiyah Peace Agreement, the Muslims would have returned back to Medina and come back the next year for Umrah. Some of the companions like Umar ibn Khattab were not too happy with the agreement because the people of Mecca were very ignorant towards the Prophet. For example, when Ali ibn Abi Talib was writing the agreement, Suhail ibn Ammar said arrogantly, "Do not write Muhammad the Messenger of Allah, write Muhammad the son of Abdullah." Ali did not want to do that, but the Prophet asked him to do what Suhail had requested. The Prophet wanted his companion to see the big picture and not to be distracted by the small details. As we will see in the beginning of this surah, Allah calls this peace agreement a great success because of the amazing results that the Muslims achieved in the long run.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the entirely merciful, the especially merciful.
إنا فتحنا لك فتحا مبينا.
Surely we have given you, O Muhammad, a great success.
ليغفر لك الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما ويتم نعمته عليك ويهديك صراطا مستقيما.
And so that Allah will forgive you for your past and your future weaknesses, perfect His approval upon you, and guide you along the straight path.
وينصرك الله نصرا عزيزا.
And so that Allah will help you greatly.
هو الذي أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم ولله جنود السماوات والأرض وكان الله عليما حكيما.
He
He is the one who sets down peace upon the hearts of the believers so they may increase even more in their faith.
ليدخل المؤمنين والمؤمنات جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ويكفر عنهم سيئاتهم وكان ذلك عند الله فوزا عظيما.
And that he may admit the believing men and the believing women to gardens beneath which rivers flow, to abide there and entirely remove them from their misdeeds. In the sight of Allah, a great attainment.
وَيُعَذِّبَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ الظَّانِّينَ بِاللَّهِ ظَنَّ السَّوْءِ عَلَيْهِمْ دَائِرَةُ السَّوْءِ وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَعَنَهُمْ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا.
And that he may punish the hypocrite men and the hypocrite women, the pious men and the pious women, those who assume about Allah an assumption of evil nature. Upon them is a misfortune of evil nature, and Allah has cursed them and prepared for them hell, and evil is a destination.
وَلِلَّهِ جُنُودُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا.
The forces of the heavens and earth belong to Allah alone, and Allah is Almighty and Wise.
Inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira.
Surely, O Prophet, we have sent you a witness, a giver of good news, and a warner.
لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُعَزِّرُوهُ وَتُوَقِّرُوهُ وَتُسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا.
And so that you believers may have faith in Allah and His Messenger, support and honor Him, and praise Allah morning and evening.
Okay, space. Good. Down. Can I hold it? Good. Good.
What we done? What we learned from this? What we learned from this surah? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this agreement was a great success because peace between the Muslims and the Meccan idol worshippers. Instead of fighting, it gave the Muslims a lot of time to make their new state in Medina stronger. It also gave the Muslims a lot of time to teach other people about Islam. Thousands of people from different tribes became Muslim during that period of peace.
Both sides were allowed to become allies with other tribes, so the Muslims gained more support in Arabia. When the Quraysh broke this peace agreement 2 years later, the Prophet led an army of 10,000 soldiers to open city compared to the 1,400 to 1,800 that had come with him for Umrah.
MashaAllah, that was a beautiful recitation. Fatima Muhammad will be speaking for us and she will be giving us a small speech.
رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Our honored teachers, caring parents, fellow hard-working graduate students and respected guests. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today, we came together to congratulate me and my fellow classmates for completing the Book of Allah. All praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for making it possible for us to learn His Qur'an in a place full of kafirs. We thank Allah for this complete life and for the gift of our peers and for everything, including every breath we take. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil and from the evil within ourselves. and make us the ones who make this ummah and Allah's deen stronger. Furthermore, to all our dear teachers, we can't or couldn't thank you enough for all your courageous efforts. This is your time to be spoiled with all that we can give you, gifts, du'as, and mostly our words. You can feel how hard it is to teach dozens of kids to start their first journey of education. Some of us, including me, didn't even know how to talk yet, and our teachers never showed any signs of impatience. It was a difficult journey, but they managed to get it done from the green book to the full book. We owe you our sincere gratitude for being the biggest positive influence of our lives. Thank you to all our teachers for guiding us and inspiring us and making us what we are today. May Allah bless them with the highest level of Jannah al-Firdaus and make their du'as come true. May Allah reward them for sacrificing their whole lives. Ameen. Secondly, to all our hardworking, never-resting parents, especially our Hoyas, we could try to thank you till the Day of Judgment, but it wouldn't be enough. You dedicated your life and ability for us to have the same experience despite the barriers. May Allah grant you the highest level of Jannah al-Firdaus and have His mercy on you. May Allah reward you for sacrificing your whole life. Ameen. Lastly, to all my fellow classmates and close friends, it was a blessing journey, but we managed to get it done perfectly. Thank you for all the laughter and challenges on who can finish it first. You guys made it fun. If it wasn't competitive, we wouldn't have finished it this early. May Allah bless you all. Everything starts with Allah and ends with Allah. So may Allah make us the ones who act upon His deen. Ya Allah, continue to guide us along the straight path and the path of those who you have blessed. Ya Allah, continue to guide us along the straight path and the path of those who you have blessed. Thank you all again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. That was a beautiful speech. May Allah accept the dua she made for us. Ameen. Lastly, we will be playing a game within us about our deen, Prophet's Quran. We will split into two equal groups, Group A and Group B. Each group will be asked 5 questions. Each group also has 5 seconds to answer and discuss each question. If there is a tie, there will be a tie-breaking question that each group can answer. The winning group will receive the gifts in this bag. You may now choose your group. One group come to this side and the other group come to this side. In this cup, it has numbers 1 through 10, so each group will choose their 5 questions randomly. Group A will start the game. First question for Group A, come up.
Hurry.
Question number 5.
Question number 5 is, what was Prophet Yunus's dua and when did he make it?
Prophet Yunus's dua is La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. And he made this dua when he was in the belly of a whale.
That is the correct answer. The score is 1-0. First question for Group B, come up.
Question number 8.
Question number 8 is, how many surahs start with Alhamdulillah?
There are 5 surahs that start with Alhamdulillah. Surah Fatiha, Surah An'am, Surah Kaf, Surah Saba, and Surah Fatir.
That is the correct answer. The score is 1-1. Second question for Group A, come up.
Question number 3.
Question number 3 is, how many doors of Jannah are there and what are their names?
There are 8 doors of Jannah. They are called Babul Salat, Babul Jihad, Babul Sadaqah, Babul Riyan, Babul Hajj, Babul Kathimin Al-Ghayd Wal-Afeen An-Nas, Babul Iman, and Babul Dhikr.
MashaAllah, that is the correct answer. The score is 2-1. Second question for Group B, come up.
Question number 4.
question number four is, in Aqira, there's a bridge called Sirat. What is it?
Sirat is a bridge set over Jahannam where everyone will cross differently. The first person to cross is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is mentioned in the Quran and described in Hadith. Sirat is thinner than a strain of hair and sharper than the sharpest sword.
MashaAllah, that is the correct answer. The score is 2-2. Third question for Group A, come up.
Question number seven.
Question number seven is, what is the inheritance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?
The inheritance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Quran and Sunnah.
That is the correct answer. The score is 3-2. Third question for Group B, come up.
Question number two.
Question number two is, what are the other names of the Quran according to the Quran itself?
The Quran describes itself as Al-Furqan, the criterion, Umul Kitab, the mother of the book, Al-Huda, the guide, and Al-Dhikr, the remembrance.
That is the correct answer. The score is 3-3. Fourth question for Group A, come up.
Question number nine.
Question number nine is, what was the dua the wife of Fir'aun Asiya made and what is the meaning?
Asiya's dua was, إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ بِنِي لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنُ وَعَمَلِهِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. It means, oh Allah, build me a house in paradise near you. Deliver me from the evil Fir'aun and save me from the wrongdoing people.
MashaAllah, that is the correct answer. The score is 4-3. Fourth question for Group B, come up.
Question number six.
Question number six is, finish this ayah and tell us the meaning. The ayah is, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا.
وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبْرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. It means your Lord has decreed that you worship nobody but him and him only, and honor your parents. If one of them or both of them reach old age under your care, you should not yell at them nor disrespect them, but speak to them honorably.
MashaAllah, that is the correct answer. The score is 4-4. Each group now has one question remaining. Group A, if you get your last question right and Group B gets it wrong, Group A will win the game. Group B, if you get your last question right and Group A gets it wrong, Group B will win the game. If both groups are tied, there will be a tie-breaking question that each group can answer. Last question for Group A, come up.
Question number one.
Question number one is, how many surahs in the Quran are named after prophets?
There are six surahs in the Quran named after prophets. Surah Yunus, Surah Hud, Surah Yusuf, Surah Ibrahim, Surah Nuh, and Surah Muhammad.
That is a correct answer. The score is 5-4. Last question for Group B, come up.
Question number 10.
Question number 10 is, how many prophets are mentioned in the Quran and what are their names?
There are 25 prophets mentioned in the Quran, and their names are Adam, Idris, Nuh, Hud, Saleh, Ibrahim, Lut, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, Yusuf, Ayyub, Shu'aib, Musa, Harun, Dhulkifli, Dawood, Sulaiman, Ilyas, Al-Yas'a, Yunus, Zakaria, Yahya, Isa, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
MashaAllah, that is a correct answer. The score is 5-5. Now that both groups are tied, Allah asks this tie-breaking question. Whichever group raises their hand first will get to answer. If they get it wrong, the other group will get a chance to win. The question is, who is the most mentioned prophet in the Quran? He is mentioned in the Quran how many times? And name one ayah that his name is mentioned in. Siham from group B, come up.
I think the most mentioned prophet in the Quran is Prophet Ibrahim. He was mentioned 70 times, and one ayah he was mentioned is وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَيَّا إِبْرَاهِيمُ.
I'm sorry, but that is the incorrect answer. Prophet Ibrahim is the second most mentioned prophet in the Quran, and he is mentioned in the Quran 69 times, not 70. Which student from group A would like to answer this question? Munira from group A, come up.
The most mentioned prophet in the Quran is Prophet Musa. He's mentioned 136 times in the Quran, and one ayah he's mentioned in is Suhufi Ibrahim wa Musa.
MashaAllah, that is the correct answer. Prophet Musa is the most mentioned prophet in the Quran. Group A has won the game. Group B, you were close when you said Prophet Ibrahim, but the correct answer is Prophet Musa. But MashaAllah, thanks for trying. It was a pleasure being here. Thank you all for listening. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Group A, you may now come up and receive your gifts. Congratulations, Group A, for winning. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you. Bismillah. Thank you to the Mali Hamdi team. As you all can witness, they were very organized and each person knew what they were supposed to do. So that's really amazing to see young people who are able to guide themselves in that setting and not panic in front of all this ice. So thank you so much. We really value you. Continuing with the program, I want to call Hayat and Nim'o to recite some tafsir of the Quran, translation of the Quran. And like I said before, it is really beneficial that we learn the meanings of the Quran. So welcome.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Surah Daman tafsirin doona mahala Surah Munafiqoon. Mahiko kawante kawitoan ayadud. سورة أنا حكوا صدقت منافقين تا especially منافقين تا مدينة منافقنا حالا قف قر إنه إله رمي سكريا مسلمتهم كأرجو إن قلبي جنا قال كه بس أنا سورة أنا بلا بسم الله ما قال لي أنكم بلا اللي هي الرحمن الحديث جود أهاني الحديث سنة اللي هي الرحيم الحديث قار أهاني الحديث سنة إذا قرت جاءك يكو إماذان المنافقون كو منافقون قالوا وحدها نشهد وحانقر أن إنك أبغل رسول الله إن رسولك ألته والله ألنا يعلم وأجه إنك أبغل رسوله إن رسولك سته والله ألا يشهد ومرقاتك يهي إن المنافقين كو منافقين لكاذبون إن يبين عليهم اتخذوا حكسما سن إيمانهم دارتوا جنة دفاع فسدوا حكل عيندتك عن سبيل الله إلى حق سامجد كيسا إنهم أيقا ساء وحاهم هذا ما شيء كانوا إيه هذا يعملونك وسمين جرى ذلك أرنت سحور على بأنهم أيقا وحقها إن آمنوا كورم ثم كذب كفروا قالوا فطبع الله وحوده ولا على قلوبهم قلوب يضل فهم أيقا لا يفقهون وحدهم فهمايا وإذا قرتي رأيتهم أعرفت كو منافقين تعجبك وكعجبنا أن أجسامهم جرك هذا وإن يقول هذا وحدها أن تسمع وادي سنة لقولهم هذا الكود كأنه محمد عينيهن خشب قللا مسندة أو ترتيسا يحسبون وحيم وذان إيغانا كل صيحة قيلك السوء عليه من كرك وذاته هم أيغا العدو وعدوك فاحذرهم اسكاء الأهلية قاتلهم الله على حلائه أن أيفكم سبي حق الولحي
ولن يؤخر الله إلهي دب مدق نفس النف إذا قرت جاءت ما تأجلها وقت هذه والله ألا خبير أوجه بما تعملون حتى سمين سان
هنا أود أتكلم قليلا باللغة العربية لأفهم فضيلة الشيخ القارئ المقري الفاضل العزيز علينا عندنا والذي زارنا من بعيد ونحن مشتاقين للقياه ورؤيته واستماع كلماته فضيلة الشيخ عكاشة وأتمنى أن يرجع مرات كثيرة بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى فضيلة الشيخ أعددنا اثنين من الطالبات سيقرأنا إن شاء الله تعالى منظومة مثلث القضربي تعصيا بفضيلتكم فمن هنا أود أن أدعو للنمعة بشير وسندس عبد الحاجي تفضل إن شاء الله تعالى لما لا قبل أضحى آخرين دونان قبي عربية وليبا آت وأذك إن أتصوصوا تامر الجينية وآت وأذك ونأغوط لقال لي سيقارة شيء عكاشة صوبتا شيء عكاشة أغوط لقال لي قبي غاس أصدع عام كؤه وقبض عائشة اللي إليها أنا أتحدث عن عائشة وقصتها وكيف استمعنا إليها قبض عائشة اللي إليها أرددي سكمة ده ما قبل قاس هذا كهر آخر ذي وكتاب عانو عادية كده من 2016 بوحان كقريب قال لي شركة دعي من يابولس أرددي أنا قار كم ده كتاب كواحد هي وان ديارنا مركا قبلة دياري لوا قبلة سجارة مثلث قدربي مركا أود أن نستمع إليهم إن شاء الله تعالى سؤال هذا كده من شيخ عكاشة مركا نبوي ريا بارك الله فيكم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الناظمي رحمه الله
حمدا لبارئ الأنام ثم الصلاة والسلام ما ناح في دوح حمام على الرسول العربي وآله وصحبه ومن تلا من حزبه سبيله في حبه على ممر الحقب وبعد فالقصد بما أردته شرحا لما وبعد فالقصد بما أردته شرحا لما قد كان قبل نظم مثلثا لقطربي مقدما فتحا على كسر فضم مسجلا وهكذا على الولا نظما على الترتب سميته بالمورث لمشكل المثلث من غير ما تريث ففوز بنيل الأرب الغمر ماء غزرة والغمر حقد سترة والغمر ذو جهل سرى فيه ولم يجرب الغمر ماء غزرة والغمر حقد سترة والغمر ذو جهل سرى فيه ولم يجرب تحية المرء السلام واسم الحجارة السلام والعرق في الكف السلام رووه في لفظ النبي تحية المرء السلام واسم الحجارة السلم والعرق في الكف السلم رووه في لفظ النبي أما الحديث فالكلام والجرح في المرء الكلام والموضع الصلب الكلام لليبس والتسلب أما الحديث فالكلام والجرح في المرء الكلام والموضع الصلب الكلام لليبس والتسلب الحرة الحجارة والحرة الحرارة والحرة المختارة من محسنات العرب الحرة الحجارة والحرة الحرارة والحرة المختارة من محسنات العرب الحلم ثقب في الآدم والحلم من خلق الكريم والحلم في النوم النعيم بالصدق أو بالكذب الحلم ثقب في الآدم والحلم من خلق الكريم والحلم في النوم النعيم بالصدق أو بالكذب السبت يوم عبدا والسبت نعل حمدا والسبت نبت مجدا في معمر أو سبسب السبت يوم عبدا والسبت نعل حمدا والسبت نبت مجدا في معمر أو سبسب وشدة الحر سهام وللنبال قل سهام ولضي الشمس السهام في مشرق أو مغرب وشدة الحر السهام وللنبال قل سهام ولضي الشمس سهام في مشرق أو مغرب ودعوة العبد دعاء ودعوة المرء دعاء ودعوة ما صنع للأكل وقت الطلب ودعوة العبد الدعاء ودعوة المرء الدعاء ودعوة ما صنع للأكل وقت الطلب الشرب جمع الندم والشرب حظ قسم والشرب فعل علم وقيل ماء العنب الشرب جمع الندم والشرب حظ قسم والشرب فعل علم وقيل ماء العنب الخرق ما قد عظم والخرق حر كرم والخرق حمق لؤم فمنه كن ذا هرب الخرق ما قد عظم والخرق حر كرم والخرق حمق لؤم فمنه كن ذا هرب عبدك للمرء لحى وقشرة العود لحى وجمع لحية لحى بالضم والكسر حبي عدلك للمرء اللحى وقشرة العود اللحى وجمع لحية اللحى بالضم والكسر حبي القسط جور رفض والقسط عدل فرض والقسط عود مرتضى من عرفه المطيب القسط جور رفض والقسط عدل فرض القسط عود مرتضى من عرفه المطيب العرف ريح طيب والعرف صبر ينذب والعرف أمر يجب عند ارتكاب الذنب العرف ريح طيب والعرف صبر ينذب والعرف أمر يجب عند ارتكاب الذنب لجنة قل لمة وشعر رأس لمة وجمع ناس لمة ما بين شخص وسب لجنة قل لمة وشعر رأس لمة وجمع ناس لمة ما بين شخص وسب العشب المسك جلد يا غلام والمسك من طيب الكرام والمسك بلغة الضعام يكفي الفتى من نشب المسك جلد يا غلام والمسك من طيب الكرام والمسك بلغة الضعام يكفي الفتى من نشب ملأ دمعي حجري وقل فيه حجري لو كنت كابني حجري لضاع مني أدبي ملأ دمعي حجري وقل فيه حجري لو كنت كنت كابن حجري لضاع مني أدبي ملأ دمعي حجري وقل فيه حجري وكنت كابن حجري لضاع مني أدبي قل ثلاثة في سرة وقرة في سرة وخرقة في سرة مشدودة من ذهب قل ثلاثة في سرة وقرة في سرة وخرقة في سرة مشدودة من ذهب العشب يدعى بالكلى وللحراسة الكلى وجمع كلية كلى لكل حي ذي أب العشب يدعى بالكلى وللحراسة الكلى وجمع كلية كلى لكل حي ذي أب الجد والد الأب والجد ضد اللعب والجد عند العرب البئر ذات الخرب الجد والد الأب والجد ضد اللعب والجد عند العرب البئر ذات الخرب جارية إحدى الجوار ومصدر الجري الجوار ورفع صوت الجؤار من وجع أو كرب جارية إحدى الجوار ومصدر الجري الجوار ورفع صوت الجؤار من وجع أو كرب وداره قد عمرت عمارة وعمرت نفس الفتى وعمرت أرضك بعد الخرب وداره قد عمرت عمارة وعمرت نفس الفتى وعمرت أرضك بعد الخرب.